Welcome students to chemistry concept, and today we are going to talk about a name reaction, Wurtz reaction, which is actually used to convert alkyl halides into alkanes. Let's have a look at the reaction and then we'll discuss its mechanism. The reaction is, let's say if I have RCH2X, an alkyl halide, it reacts with sodium metal in presence of dry ether. Now, why dry ether? Ether is the solvent, and why is it dry? Because we have sodium. Sodium reacts with moisture violently, so we need a solvent free from moisture or water. So alkyl halide reacts with sodium to form a higher set of alkane. Plus 2 moles of sodium halide are released. Now, if you see that number of carbon atoms get doubled. If I start with an alkyl halide of carbon 2, I'll be getting an alkane of carbon 4. If I start with 3, I'll be getting 6. Example is, if I start with CH3Cl heated with sodium, then actually what happens, that 2 moles of CH3Cl will react with 2 moles of sodium. This will come out and we will be getting CH3 plus 2 moles of sodium chloride. You can also understand it this way, that we have CH3Cl plus 2 moles of sodium, then there is another ClCH3, this portion is removed, and then we get CH3 plus 2 moles of NaCl. So this is how it takes place, and the key factor is the limitation. The key factor is that carbon atoms get doubled. As I just told, that I started with alkyl halide of 1 carbon, I get an alkane of 2 carbon. If I start with an alkyl halide of 3 carbons, I'll be getting that of 4 carbons. So this is an advantage, that whenever I want to double the number of carbon atoms, I can use this method. And this is the limitation also, that using Wurtz reaction, I cannot prepare an alkane of odd number of carbon atoms. Obviously, because double of anything is always even. Even if I have an odd number of carbon, let's say 3, its double would be 6. So, using this method, it is not possible to prepare an alkane with odd number of carbon atoms. But someone may say one thing, that there is a trick. What if I use a mixture of CH3CH2Cl, that is a compound, an alkyl halide with 2 carbon, and CH3Cl, an alkyl halide with 1 carbon, then heated with sodium and ether, then is it like I'll be getting 2 from here, 1 from here, and I'll get CH3 plus 2 moles of NaCl? So this is how I can get it. The answer is yes. This is a way by which I can prepare an alkane of odd number of carbon atoms using 2 different alkyl halides, but this is not the only product I'll be getting in this reaction. This type of reaction, in which I am using 2 different type of alkyl halide, I'll get 3 different products. One would be from 2 molecules of ethane, that is CH2 butane. One would be from 2 molecules of chloromethane, that is CH3. And the third one would be the desired I was looking for, one this and this. Okay? So I'll be getting a mixture of three different products with similar boiling points, and it will not be possible to separate them out. That is why this method is not good for the preparation of alkyl halides with odd number of carbon atoms. Now let's do a practice question. Okay, let's say if I ask you that do Wurtz reaction of CH3, CH2, CH3, or let's say this CH2, Cl. That is 2 chloro propane. What would be the product formed when this one is reacted with sodium in dry ether? Then the answer is again, but what I'll do, let's write it in this way: CH3 CH CH3 Cl. One molecule, another molecule is CH3 CH Cl CH3, reacting with 2 moles of sodium. Let us eliminate this part, and what we'll be getting is CH3 CH CH3 CH CH3 CH3. That's it. Or 1, 2, 3, 4. The name is, yes, it is 2, 3 di methyl butane. I hope the mechanism and the concept is clear for the Wurtz reaction. It is an important reaction. And keep in mind both things, that what is Wurtz reaction, why is it used, and what is its limitation. Stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe for more videos of organic, inorganic and physical chemistry. Thank you.